everybody. Welcome to the Wolf Den Podcast. How's everybody doing? I hope everybody's good. We're good. How are you, Will?
Doing pretty fantastic on this Tuesday before Thanksgiving. I got myself a new toy, Bob. May I show it off?
Yeah, you may. It better be a snack.
I bought it. It's not. It's the Doom Slayer.
What is that, and why is he bronze?
So McFarlane Toys, this is Toy Time with Will Wolf. McFarlane Toys has the Doom license, so they make all the Doom toys. The regular green Doom Slayer figure, just they don't make it anymore. Screw you. You missed your chance. The Phobos variant, which is this bronze version, again, the variant, the one that's supposed to be hard to find, is still readily available and still retails for $20. So that's the one I got. He is a thick boy and not very poseable.
What is the Phobos variant?
I think it's based on Doom Eternal, which I haven't played, but I think there's a part where you go to Phobos is one of the moons of Mars, and I think he wears orange or bronze at that part. So that explains that. You can also get the Doomicorn variant, which is just the white unicorn armor that he wears as a goof. You can get that figure. That is also readily available and still $20. Not the regular green Doom Slayer.
Doomicorn? Oh! Yeah. Oh!
Right?
Why didn't you get this, dude?
Because I think my daughter's getting it for Christmas.
Dude, $20?
Yeah.
That looks sick.
Wolf, Will.
I know, right?
Did you hear that?
I did.
Why? I have notifications muted. Anyway, yo, I want this. How do I get, is it on Amazon?
It's Amazon! On Amazon. Yeah.
That's so, this is so stupid.
Ask your Amazon device to order you.
Alexa. Order me the McFarlane Toys Doom Slayer Doomicorn action figure. A top result is McFarlane Toys Doom Slayer Doomicorn action figure. $19.99. That's the one.
There you go.
With delivery by tomorrow. Yeah, add it to my cart, please. Nope. She stopped listening. I'm just gonna add it to my cart myself.
There you go.
My Echo goes through my headphones because it's plugged into my speakers.
Oh, okay.
Wow. All right. Sorry, everybody who has an Amazon Echo. You now all own Doom Slayer Doomicorn. I'm not sorry at all. You all deserve that. Yeah. Thank you, Trevel Steinberg, for the 8 months. Happy 8 month anniversary, Bob. Hello, Trevel. Thank you so much. I feel like it's been longer than that. Insane Pixel. Thank you for the host. Zavala, thank you for the 3 months. Hi, Will. And then the Will Wolf emoji.
Hi.
Kikoba with the 600 bits. It's a shame Will had to leave the show. All right. Well, anyway. Today is the Black Friday special. We get to just go through all the Black Friday circulars.
That's right. By all, really, I just put Target and Best Buy in there. Really, I've noticed the Black Friday deals, especially for video games, is the same across the board. There might be like a $5 difference or so here and there. But I think Best Buy is selling Star Wars Squadrons for $20, but Target is selling it for $25.
You absolute fool?
What?
Kohl's.
Oh,
Kohl's is where it's at.
The dark horse of Black Friday.
Kohl's is where it's at. They had PS5s for like a while.
They did, yeah.
But yeah, if you go to blackfriday.com, it has all the circulars for all the different whatchamacallit.
Major retailers.
Yeah, you just go to blackfriday.com. It looks like this. And it's got all the circulars. The circular being the little magazine advertisement that has all the good deals. If you're looking for a deal on the new consoles, too bad.
Yeah. You should have known that going in, you were not going to get a deal on the PlayStation 5 or the Series X or S.
Be lucky to even find one.
Yeah, especially that. Also, I'm not seeing deals on last gen systems either.
Ooh, that's dumb.
Yeah, you would think at the very least, because Microsoft always discounts the Xbox One around this time, you would think they would sell an Xbox One for $100.
Mm-hmm.
Like that would be like the perfect doorbuster.
Yeah.
But I'm not seeing that anywhere. And we should always remember Nintendo is doing their Black Friday deal, which is not a deal at all.
Did you put that in? Oh, you did. Yeah,
I put the eShop in.
Oh, okay. Well, they had one on Twitter. I can't open Twitter on stream because you never know what's gonna pop up. I quote tweeted them because they had a flyer that they put up, and I don't blame them, but there is not a single every single thing on this. This is Nintendo New York City. This is the store here in New York, the only American Nintendo store, and the only one in the world until November.
That's not entirely true because there is a Nintendo store in the Nintendo Redmond office. If you go to the Nintendo of America offices in Redmond, Washington, there is a store, but it's for employees only.
Yeah, of course. So every single thing that's on this list is full price, which is kind of amazing because you have things like Breath of the Wild, which came out 3 years ago.
Yeah.
So, this just amazes me. But, I mean, the Switch is still selling like hotcakes, so you can't really blame them. It is kind of cool that the Animal Crossing Switch is still readily available.
Yeah, that is cool. I do want to say, though, so they have the Mario Kart 8 bundle. It's the Switch system. It comes with Mario Kart 8 Deluxe and 3 months of Nintendo Switch Online for free.
Oh, I didn't know that last part.
That is the same bundle they've been releasing for the past 3 years.
But has it always had Switch Online?
I believe so.
I don't remember the Switch Online part.
Well, either way, it's the Nintendo Switch and Mario Kart 8 again.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody who owns a Switch owns that game already.
That's the thing. This is for people who don't own a Switch because they're buying the Switch. Also, it's for people like if you have two kids and you're buying one for the other kid. They're also going to need a Mario Kart.
True.
I get a lot of DMs asking for technical advice or buying advice or whatever. I got one from a mom who bought two Switches and only one Mario Kart 8 thinking that they would work across both. So this is for her.
Yeah.
Anyway. Oh, and they have Mario Kart Live. So when is Express shopping list? Only our friendly and knowledgeable staff are here to assist you with all of your holiday shopping needs. To serve you fast, Nintendo New York will stock all of the top Nintendo products for the holiday season, beginning November 20th. Beginning November 20th, get all of the same stuff you could always get. I guess they're just letting you know that they're going to have Mario Kart Live in stock and all this other stuff. Mario Kart Live should be bigger. That should be
that's
a much bigger deal.
A big thing this year. I do want to point out as Funds64 called me out in the chat, heads up that Mario Kart 8 Switch bundle includes the newer Switch console, which has a quote-unquote longer battery life, whatever that means. So he is correct that for the first time it's going to be the updated Switch, which has the hour longer battery, and you can't stick a paperclip in it to hack it like you can the other version.
Oh you still can you can.
Okay.
I thank you. Well, yeah, I'm pretty sure you can. Anyway, Yeah, I forgot that. Last year, the Mario Kart bundle was still the old Switch. But now they're all the new Switch.
Yes.
Maybe they did throw in the 3 months of... I don't know. But Wolf Den Dad in the chat says, you can catch me in the Nintendo store in Japan on the Wolf Den YouTube channel. Hashtag Wolf Den Dad. False. You can catch him just outside of the Nintendo store in Japan because we couldn't get in when we were there. Anyway, what should we look at?
But you can catch him in the Snoopy store in Japan.
True.
Over on Bob's personal channel. Or is that in the Wolf Den?
No, it's the Wolf Den one. He's like walking out of the Snoopy store.
Yeah.
What should we do first, Will? Should we do GameStop? I feel like GameStop's important.
True. Hey, GameStop is always on the cusp of not being important anymore.
True. I also want to note that all of this stuff should be available online and you should not go to the store.
Yes, absolutely, 100%. Do not go. I mean, we've often said don't go Black Friday shopping because of the crowds and whatnot. This year especially because there is still a coronavirus out there.
So we always put up a disclaimer before these shows and say, do not go shopping on Thanksgiving. Because these people are being forced to work earlier and earlier on Thanksgiving, and it's now it's been bleeding into dinner time. People have to get there.
Yeah,
I mean, stores have been opening at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and that means employees have to get there at like 3 to start like prepping for the Black Friday and whatnot. So it's not fair to them. They should get a freaking they should have a holiday to themselves.
Exactly.
But this Thanksgiving, finally, it only took a global pandemic. Stores are actually opening on Friday and not on Thanksgiving. At least I don't see any that are opening on Thanksgiving. Like the doorbusters aren't on Thanksgiving anymore, which is great. But that being said, just buy it online. Another helpful tip, if you want to buy stuff online, like let's say you are waiting maybe for the PS5 and Xbox Series X or S to show up. Go to either nowinstock.net. Is it net or com? No, it's net. Nowinstock.net or zoolert.com. These two sites are what scalpers use to buy up all of the, all the stuff. Yeah. So I'm on nowinstock.com right now. You can see the PlayStation 5. It has... everything's out of stock, but you just leave this in a tab open with your speakers blasting and you hit alarm on. It's on right now. And once it is available in stock on one of these, it'll make this sound.
That's please, not annoying.
Please shut up. And that'll wake your ass up and you run to your computer and it'll show you where it's in stock and then you just buy it up. This actually helped our friend Greg, who works at Best Buy. He couldn't get his hands on a PS5. I told him about this, and I said, actually, Zoolert, I think, lets you select if you only wanted to see if it's available at Best Buy. And he did that, and it woke him up at 5 in the morning, and there was stock available, and he was able to get a PS5 because of that. Both of these websites are good. Maybe leave them both open. If you want a specific site, I think Zoolert will let you do a specific site. It might take some finagling. Otherwise, good luck getting a PS5 or Xbox Series X. Now, Sony is not selling any in stores at all.
Right.
So
they're not doing that until next year, I think.
Do not go to any store early expecting to grab a PS5. Don't start waiting online, on Thanksgiving, expecting to get in to get a PS5. You're not going to get it. Xbox, there's like a potential you might. I don't think Best Buy is doing it at all, right?
Yeah, Best Buy isn't.
Best Buy won't let you have an Xbox Series X in store at all. So if you want a new console, that's... your only bet is to go to those websites, Zoolert or nowinstock.net. Anyway, let's take a notification break. We have a lot, and I lost my spot. Diet Andy with 20 months should be more, but I suck at the reminder belt. Dude, you don't worry about it. 20 months is a lot of months. Thank you.
Yeah.
Warlock with 2 months. Thank you. Dante Mira with a hundo bits. Nello FN with 6 months. Muaka? Muaka? What does that mean?
I'm Googling it. Hold on.
Oh, look, it's Eddie. Thanks for the host. Funds 64 with 5 months. Payment derped. Glad to be a wolf denite. Again, we're glad to have you. 200 bits from Spyro. Thank you. Hello. Above Heavens. Thank you for the Prime subscription.
Muak is kiss.
Oh, it's like a smack.
Like muak. Yeah.
Mm.
So they're kissing us.
I hope you're of age. Ghost, yes, of Gordy. Thank you for the 6 months. Eric is correct. You go online, but you stand in line. Love you guys. All right, I think it's a Long Island thing to say wait online. Like when you're physically in line.
I don't think online. We do say online, probably because we say we're on Long Island.
Yes.
That's how you can tell if somebody's not from here, FYI. Mm-hmm. But I'm pretty sure standing online, that's like a universal thing. Like, I know now, especially with the younger generation, online means like on your computer or your phone or whatnot. But I don't know. I just always assumed online was, you know, I'm waiting online.
Is that what this is? Are we old? And that's why we say online?
I think we're just old. Yeah.
It's like how our parents call videos tapes.
Yes.
Damn. We just got seen. I don't like it. I don't appreciate it. We just got boomered. All right. You know what? Best Buy. We'll do Best Buy.
Okay.
Best Buy is probably the easiest or most important anyway.
Just a note, the Best Buy games deals don't start until page 25 because there's 10 solid pages of TVs.
Any good ones though? Like,
I don't know. I just kept hitting next until I got to something that wasn't a TV.
All right. So another thing to note is, I mean, people are going to want TVs for their new consoles. Yeah. There's always Black Friday special TVs that they make like, specifically for Black Friday.
Yeah,
I have one. I
have two.
Oh. They're good.
Yeah.
I mean, they are cheaper though. They're made cheaper specifically for Black Friday. Mine, the panel died. It had a dead pixel line, but Samsung had good support, and the guy came with a new panel and replaced it in my apartment during the pandemic.
I don't think the one in my basement might not be, but the one in my living room definitely is. But that said, it's still a good TV. It does everything I need it to. It's 4K. It has HDR. Really, when you get like the Black Friday specials, you're missing like an HDMI port, and maybe it doesn't do high frame rate, high refresh rate. Mm-hmm. But if you want a good TV at a decent price, that's not a problem to shop on Black Friday. If you want like the Cadillac of televisions, then Black Friday might not be your best option because it just won't be any cheaper.
If you're looking for a TV specifically for the new consoles, you want HDMI 2.1.
Yes.
You want 4K at 120 hertz, a real 120 hertz. If it has an asterisk next to it, forget about it. If it has, if it says like a motion scaled to 120 hertz,
if it says 120 hertz, but it has like something like motion, like true motion or anything like that,
So, yeah, that's what you want. And a lot of TVs, they'll have multiple HDMI ports, but only one will be 2.1. And that kind of sucks because they don't make 2.1 switchers yet. So if you have both consoles, it could be a problem.
Yeah.
maybe you just plan on getting one at first, then having one HDMI 2.1 port isn't that big of a deal, because by the time you get the next one, you'll have a switcher.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's what you want to look for. And HDR, I mean, HDR is still a mystery to me. Like, there's like 1,000 different versions of HDR. It's hard to nail down which one is exactly the one that you're going to need. So, we're here with the Best Buy game deals. Here you go. Buy a PS5 for the normal price, but not now, coming soon. All of this stuff is normal price. Wait, Spider-Man? Yeah. No,
that's the special edition.
Yeah, forget that. Yeah. Okay. What else we got? Red Dead 2, page, $20.
Yeah.
That's a pretty good deal. A lot of last gen stuff's going to be like super on sale.
Yeah. Star Wars Squadrons, that game just came out and it's already half price at Best Buy.
I need to get that.
That's not bad.
I need to get that. So, will if I get the Xbox version. Oh, wait, it says it right here.
Yeah.
It says Xbox Series X, baby. All right, I'm getting that. Let me write that down.
I remember like last time I was on the show, we talked about like EA's plans for next gen, and there was something specific about Squadrons that I think on the Xbox it has more features than it does on the PS5.
I think it does 120 hertz on Xbox and it doesn't on PS5 or something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
That seems to be happening. That's happening with Call of Duty Warzone.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, it's promoted more on, like, they have a deal with PlayStation to give it stuff first on PlayStation. All right, so I'm gonna get Star Wars Squadrons on. You said it was $30 on Target or something.
It was $25 at Target. It's $20 at Best Buy.
Also, Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2 is $30 at Best Buy.
There you go.
And Avengers is $30. Now that's a little sad.
That's a game that just came out, and that's $30.
That has a sad story. Oh, Seagate. Yeah. Oh, PS4 drive. Get out of here. Old news. Don't care about you. What's this? New releases for the holiday. Oh, it's just new releases.
Yeah.
Those are probably full price. Showing off Yakuza. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Coming soon. Xbox Switch games. $30.
Final Fantasy VII, $30. That's not bad.
That's not bad. That's not bad.
Death Stranding, $20. If you missed it.
I missed it. I still got to get through that.
God of War, Horizon Zero Dawn, The Last of Us Remastered, each are $10. I feel like they did that last year. But yeah, those are fantastic for all those games.
I remember them being that cheap last year.
Yeah.
But yeah, $10 for those games. Amazing. Yeah. Especially Horizon. I feel like Horizon, that's a great deal.
Yeah.
For the low, low price of $70, you can own Black Ops. Demon Souls. I've been playing Demon Souls. I played a little bit of Demon Souls on stream the other day. It's freaking great.
Yeah,
it's actually great, and it's not like as frustrating as everybody says it is, because there's no like real checkpoints, but you open up, you unlock little like areas that let you quickly go back to where you were. So there's like kind of checkpoints. It's cool. I like it a lot.
Nice.
I fell into it, and I'm kind of like craving playing it some more. Ghost of Tsushima, $40.
That's good.
That's a good deal.
Again, that's a new game. So
these are games we're gonna be like. I'm trying to find some games that I want to like pinpoint and like stick to for when we look at the other stores. And Ghost of Tsushima, $40 is a fantastic deal.
Yeah.
Google Stadia, dude, controller. Do not buy that.
I got my free one. Still have not like hooked it up and played with it yet.
I don't think I ever actually put my address in. Like, I got the deal, but I don't think I put the information in.
So like a day or two after I signed my wife up for it, but we missed the promotion, so now she just has Google Stadia for a month. and no controller.
I might be in that boat.
Yeah.
Even though I already have Google Stadia.
Yeah.
Now we're on the Switch stuff. I didn't realize there was no Switch stuff this whole time.
Yeah.
For the low price of $60, you can own Super Mario 3D All-Stars.
Well, that's good because you better get it now because come March, that's it.
That's it. You're not getting it. $40 yeah. for Super Mario Maker 2. Not bad. I'd say not bad.
$40 for Link's Awakening as well.
And Luigi's Mansion 3.
And Luigi's Mansion.
This is pretty low. I mean, I've seen Mario Maker 2 for that low this year.
For Nintendo, this is a good deal.
Yeah, I'd say also, for Luigi's Mansion and Link's Awakening, that's a good deal. I mean, for Mario Maker, it's good, but I've seen it that low before.
Yeah. Also on this page, for $60, a 400 gig Nintendo branded SD card.
So $60 is not a good deal for a $400 gigabyte micro SD card, but it right. is a good deal for the Nintendo branded one.
Right. Yeah.
And the Nintendo branded one might be like a hair faster,
mm-hmm.
but it is, that's I never did any testing with it. It just turns out that is like the exact spec that a Switch needs, I think.
Yeah.
I don't know. I did a whole video on it. Watch that video.
Yeah, but if you want a blue-shelled SD card, now's your chance.
It's pretty cool looking.
Apparently, the 512 gig micro SD card, Nintendo branded micro SD card, is Animal Crossing.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Nightmare SR in the chat says 500 gigabyte is $65 on Amazon.
All right, well, screw Best Buy.
I don't know if he means the. He says the Samsung one. So that's not the branded one.
Right, right.
Yeah, but don't you want it to have freaking Animal Crossing on it?
Yeah, man, come on.
I still have not gotten my 1 terabyte into my Switch yet.
Really?
Yeah, I tried transferring it over the old-fashioned, like putting it into the console and transferring everything over. There's always a problem. So I have to just literally plug it in and re-download everything, and I'm kind of dreading
it. Yeah, when I transferred everything over to my 400, it was a nightmare.
Did you plug it into the computer, or did you just download it?
Right again? I tried plugging it into the computer. Did not work no matter what I did. So I just re-downloaded everything.
I'll be honest, it's kind of quick, just straight up re-downloading it. Maybe I'll do that tonight. I got to film some stuff. Super Mario U Deluxe, $35, that's pretty good.
That's not bad for a last-gen game. Actually, would that technically be a retro game now? Where are we?
No, because... So it depends on your... definition.
My usual definition is you have current gen, last gen, and anything before last gen is retro.
I agree with your definition.
We're in this weird nebulous stage where there is technically no current gen. There's still next gen, but current gen has become last gen.
So
does that make sense?
The problem is Nintendo, because the Switch was classified as a current gen when it really wasn't.
Well, it's not even really Nintendo, because, you know, the Xbox Series X, yes, is a next generation system, making the Xbox One the last generation Xbox. Mm-hmm. But games are still being released for both. You know, games are optimized for one but can still work on the other. You know, they're still putting out games for the last gen while they're trying to put out games for the next gen. So there really isn't really a current gen. There's next gen and last gen to differentiate the two. But until the Series X and the PS5 get settled, they're next gen still. And the PS4 and the Xbox One are last gen.
I think
there
this
is technically no current gen.
I think this always happens the holiday when the new systems come out.
Right.
Nobody has them yet.
Yeah.
So everybody still calls them next gen. It takes a while for people to switch over. But I think the Wii U is technically in the 360. It's technically in the 360 generation, isn't it?
I mean, hardware wise, it's in the 360 generation. And it came out in the 360 generation, but then the next year, the PS4 and the Xbox One came out. The Wii U is technically in that generation because it's the next Nintendo system.
Okay, so you're right. The Wii U is in the eighth generation, according to Wikipedia, which I don't like.
But so is the Switch.
That's what I don't like. The Switch should be in the next generation. It should be in the ninth generation. Which isn't a thing on this wiki article yet. It just says current consoles.
Yeah.
So it goes from eighth generation to current consoles.
Yeah. I mean, the Switch might be the first cross-generation console.
It should. Actually, we'll see what happens. I feel like in March, we're going to get that iteration we've been waiting for. Mm-hmm. I feel like it was supposed to happen now. Anyway, you got Yoshi's Crafty World for $35. Don't get that you have a very small child. Yeah. Mario plus Rabbids, $15. That's a great deal. I hate that game, though.
Kingdom Hearts 3 Special Edition, $10.
Here's an interesting thing. They're selling the Rocketfish dock, which is a rebranding of the Insignia dock.
Huh.
Interesting. And it's only $25.
Yeah.
Now, I would advise not getting this. However, there was a point in time that we discovered on this podcast where Nintendo linked directly to the Insignia dock from their website because they were just sold out of Nintendo branded docks, so they just linked directly to the Insignia dock. I don't know if that was an endorsement from Nintendo, but it seemed like it to me. So if you have a warranty on your Switch or you don't really give a shit, then there you go. Buy this. That's really it.
Yeah.
What else? The future of gaming is here. Nothing great. Oh, $45 for Game Pass. That's not a deal.
Oh, save $20 on select controllers. So you can get an Xbox Series X controller for $40.
No. Which is, No. That is an Xbox One controller.
No. If you go to the website, you can get the Xbox Series controllers for $40.
Oh. Yeah. I saw this deal on somewhere. Maybe it was Best Buy. Oh, the Xbox One controllers have such better colors.
They do. The Xbox One's been out for longer.
They got to get the custom
design lab.
Yeah, they got to get the design lab up and running for this. Why not? All right, it's the same stuff.
So here's since we're allowed to curse now on this podcast, let me just bring up that Microsoft is back on their bullshit with the blue controller being more expensive than the regular controllers just because it's a different color.
That's messed up, Will.
I hate that so much.
I'm gonna write a letter.
I hate the fact that controllers are expensive as it is. They shouldn't be this expensive, especially the Microsoft controller. But charging you $5 more, in this case at least $5 more, just to have a different color is ludicrous.
I get it. Because nobody wants the regular one. And sometimes you just need a controller, you know? Sometimes your controller breaks and you just need a controller. That's when you get the stupid looking one, the black or white one. But if you want the cool one, it's premium. Well, you got to pay a premium price.
That's the thing. Like, I always want the cool one.
I know that. And you're willing to pay $5 for it. So there you go. They got you. But blue is stupid. Like, come on. Give me
more
than that.
No, that's a nice one. That's a nice one.
I don't. I need more than that. Also,
I agree with you. They should be putting out more colors, but that's a nice blue.
I also really hope that they give us different colored D pads and sticks. Oh, they do have different colored sticks. Okay,
they have different colored sticks. The D pad. I mean, on the Series controllers, they're all black. But maybe down the road they'll give us different colored ones.
I hope so, because I'm not about that. But this is great. I mean, the Xbox controller you can play it on PC and stuff, and it connects to Android phones really easily. This is like the most versatile controller. So
they said coming soon, it will work on iOS and Mac devices.
Mm. So this is a great thing to have.
Yeah.
Also, it might end up working on smart TVs. There was an article that I didn't put that Phil Spencer said they're working on getting Game Pass to be on smart TVs, which is going to run like absolute trash. You know how long it takes for you to freaking change the channel on a smart TV, like, or to open up the YouTube app? Like,
I was going to say, this is why I always recommend getting like a Roku stick or like a third party streaming device and not rely on the apps built into your TV. Cause you know, they're a lot better than they were a few years ago, but they're still slow. They're still buggy. They're still not as reliable as using an Apple TV or a Fire TV or anything like that.
So they have deals on the hard drives for PS4 and Xbox One.
Yes.
You can, I guess, use these to store games on your newer consoles. Like maybe if you have an Xbox Series S and you want to store games.
Yes.
But you don't expect to run games off of it, you know?
It should be noted that as of now, you cannot store PS5 games on an external device of any kind. It can only be done on the built-in internal SSD. You can't even add your own SSD.
That is very true. I forgot about that.
I know that's coming soon. Like that's going to be patched in, but it's not right now.
I have to. There's a deal on the Rocketfish Play and Charge Kit for the Xbox One, and I gotta send that to our friend Jerry.
Mm. Yeah, he is the audience for the Rocketfish.
No, he specifically said he wanted to get one.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess that's it. Coming soon, featured games. Nope. Don't care. Ori and the Will of the Wisps for Xbox. $13. That's pretty damn good.
There you go. Ooh, Gears 5 for $5.
What?
Yeah.
When did that game come out?
Last year. It came out last year, but that game is like being touted as one of the showcases for the Series X. Because it can run in 4K 120.
It can only in multiplayer.
Only in multiplayer, but still.
Also, Halo 5 Guardians, $10.
Yeah.
Damn. Persona 5, PS4, $15. These are pretty good.
Yeah. Shadow of the Tomb Raider, $13.
All right. Can we... Oh, and Resident Evil 2 and 3, $15. I did see that. I saw Wario 64 talk about that. Let's move on to Target. I want to see if Target usually has the buy two, get one free. Or do they do that before Black Friday?
I think they do that before.
Well, I guess we missed it.
Yeah.
I like that because then you get some new games. That's the only way you get a deal on new games is Target's buy two, get one free.
Yeah. So I don't know if you can see, but like this isn't everything. It says over 50 games for $25, over 60 games for $15, and so on.
Mm-hmm.
But I think this is a good like overview of what they're offering.
Ghost of Tsushima for $40, which is the same as Best Buy.
Yeah.
Also, Watch Dogs Legions for PS5, $40.
That's a good deal.
It says available Tuesday. I don't know what that means.
Yeah. They're probably not out yet. It's probably when this circular came out, it probably wasn't out yet.
Interesting.
Yeah. But Star Wars Squadrons for $25. It's only like $5 more than Best Buy.
Mario plus Rabbids $15. That was the same.
Yeah, wasn't that $15?
Right?
Yeah.
I think so. Oh, they also have Lion King and Aladdin for $15. That's pretty good.
They have Sonic Mania and Sonic Team Sonic Racing combo pack for $25.
There's a combo pack for that?
Yeah, they put out the two combo packs, Sonic Mania and Sonic Team Racing, and Super Monkey Ball, Banana Blitz, and Sonic Forces.
I believe that Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2 for $25 is a better deal than Best Buy.
Yes.
I need to pull that up and make doubly sure. It was 30 at Best Buy.
Yeah, Jedi Fallen Order is 25 at Target. What was it at Best Buy?
I don't remember seeing it at all at Best Buy. I
saw it. Now I gotta go back through all the.
I don't see it at all. All
right, if I see it, I'll bring it up.
All right. Okay. What else we got? Oh, Luigi's Mansion 40. All the Nintendo stuff 40. That's you know.
Yeah.
Mario U Deluxe is 40. That wasn't 40 at Best Buy.
Crap.
It was 35 at Best Buy. It's cheaper at Best Buy. God of War, $10. Sonic Mania, $10. All for PS4. I don't see. It says over 50 games, so I'd assume that Horizon and The Last of Us are also $10.
Yeah, I'm sure that's included in it.
The Last of Us Part 2, it says 30.
$30.
That is a good deal.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Yeah, I think so.
Target was easy.
Yeah. Again, that's only a sampling, so you might want to check their website or in store.
They have some pretty good TV deals.
They do. LG, they don't have 1,000 pages worth of TV deals, but
LG NanoCell HDR, 4K. I think those are 120 hertz. 55 inches though. All right, anyway. I guess that's it. So there's some games are cheaper at Target.
Yeah.
Let's do a wild card and look at Kohl's, Will.
Oh boy.
Kohl's is the sleeper hit. Because Kohl's gives you Kohl's cash.
Yeah.
You don't expect Kohl's to have electronics.
Nope.
And then they do. And then you get cash and you spend it on more electronics.
Or a nice pair of dungarees.
Nice pair of dungarees for yourself. I have no idea what page the friggin' games are going to be on.
I had it and then I lost it. So I think it's pretty early.
I'm just skipping around. I got mixers. I got pots and pans here. What we do have is 5 months from MCU's Bob.
Hello. Page 4.
Oh my God, I skipped right over like a big old idiot. All right, here we go. You got a little gaming rocking chair for $40. You got a nice Xbox One controller that's red for $55.
Wow, but you earned $15 in Kohl's cash.
That's it. Okay, so this is actually, Kohl's is doing us dirty right now. Kohl's is worthless to us. They do have the Mario Kart Switch bundle.
Yes.
But, oh my God, they have freaking Link's Awakening for $60. That's horrible.
Yeah.
And what is this thing? Go Retro Portable Handheld Gaming Device. What the hell is this thing? Ew.
Yeah, no. Kohl's is bad this year.
Oh, it has Burger Time on it.
Oh, never mind.
Kohl's is bad. I was expecting some Kohl's cash with the Switch, but nah. Garbage. Kohl's is garbage. All right, GameStop. Let's see what. Let's see if they could redeem this. Not really. Avengers, $26.99. I think it was $20 at Best Buy.
Yeah. Either way, not a great for a game that's just came out.
No, it was $30 at Best Buy, so it is cheaper at GameStop.
Oh wow.
Watch Dogs Legion's $32.99. I think it was cheaper at Target. How much was it at Target? I believe it was $40 at Target.
It was $40.
So $32.99.
Well, keep in mind that these are doorbusters.
Oh.
So those are usually like right when the store opens.
True. Okay. And that, I think that means you have to be there.
Yeah.
So we should just forget this entire. GameStop's Black Friday 2020 sale kicks off with their Black Friday countdown event starting November 14th, followed by the Black Friday early deals event on November 22nd. Game enthusiasts can shop GameStop's doorbusters, which will include up to 50% off headsets and PC bundles. Stores open Friday, November 27th at 7 a.m. Shop GameStop.com Wednesday, 8 p.m. Central Time. So I guess the doorbusters count for that? For maybe. Wednesday? Oh, wait, it says it. No, it does not say it. Never mind. Available for Xbox, PS5, and PS4. It just says Xbox. It doesn't say what.
I think at this point it's like, who cares?
Yeah, who cares? Mortal Kombat 11. Is this Aftermath?
Is that the complete game or is that just the expansion? Because I think they sell the Aftermath expansion by itself, but you need the full game to play it.
Oh, never mind.
Wait. No, it says includes Mortal Kombat 11 and like the DLC.
Oh, $27.
So that's a good deal. I might get that.
These are some good deals. Watch Dogs. This is the best deal you'll get at Watch Dogs. And
Star
Avengers.
Wars Squadrons for $16.99.
Ooh. Jedi Fallen Order, $30. Is that the same as a... What was it, Target?
No, that Target was
$25. Where do you see Star Wars Squadrons?
First page.
Oh, there it is. Wow. Okay. I'm going to write that down. I'm going to do a little slash GameStop because I don't know if I'll be able to get a GameStop. We don't know if these are doorbusters or like you have to be there or what.
Yeah.
Resident Evil 3, $20. Not a good deal. It was cheaper at Best Buy, I believe.
Yeah.
Mario plus Rabbids, $20.
I think it was cheaper at Best Buy.
$30 for Tony Hawk. That's not a good deal. Ghost of Tsushima, $40. That's kind of the run of the mill.
Yeah.
Last of Us Part 2, $30. That's, yeah, the same.
Spider-Man and Doom are also that at other places.
Okay. I'm going to say avoid GameStop because we don't even know if you have to be there for these deals. these might be doorbusters. Death Stranding 20, that was the same deal. $16.99 for Resident Evil 2, that's almost a deal, but not really.
Yeah.
GameStop's looking like pretty trash right now.
Yeah. No good. Yeah, even the Xbox controller deal is not good.
Wow.
It's only $10 off instead of $20.
Wow. They have the same Mario Kart 8 bundle just like everyone else is going to have. Ooh, wait, here we go. PDP Fight Pad controller for the Nintendo Switch. This is the GameCube controller. I like these.
Oh, yeah.
They're USB GameCube controllers. $12.49. That's a pretty good deal. They also have $14.99 for the Power A pro-ish controllers.
Mm-hmm.
They're wired. Well, those are pretty good. So you got some good Nintendo Switch accessories on here.
Yeah. Here are two game deals that I think are interesting. They're both Xbox One, but they might be also on PS4. It's the Arcane Collection, and that includes the three Dishonored games and Prey for $30.
Hmm.
And then there's Wolfenstein, the Alt History Collection, which includes all the new Wolfenstein games from this generation, the New Order, the Old Blood, the New Colossus, and Young Blood for $40.
Oh, that's
all. I would say if you've never played any of the new Wolfenstein games, definitely get that, because at the very least, the New Order and the New Colossus are fantastic. The New Order might be my favorite game of the generation. I know that's weird.
That is weird.
But like, I really enjoyed that game a lot more than I thought I would. So,
BioShock Collection for the Switch, $15. Oh no, $20. $20 for.
I haven't seen that for $20.
Have you seen Let's Go Eevee and Pikachu for $30?
I've not seen that anywhere.
I think that's a pretty good deal. GameStop right here, baby.
Yeah.
Okay. That's really all I'm seeing for a Switch.
Yeah.
Are they still selling The Witcher for $50? Are you kidding me?
I saw that at Best Buy for cheaper on the Switch.
Pre-owned DualShock 4 and Xbox One controllers for $30.
Ah, there you go. That's how they get you.
Buy two, get one free. Pre-owned PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and Nintendo Switch games and 3DS games.
Or buy two, get two free PlayStation 3, Xbox 360, Nintendo Wii, DS, PlayStation Vita, and Nintendo Wii U games.
I would say that's a good deal because
yes,
you're only getting that stuff used anyway. Like, you're not getting new versions of, because those are retro by now.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool. Maybe I'll we gotta hope that this is online.
Yeah.
So it looks like it is. No, yeah. I don't know. I can't tell. Oh, it says Sunday, November 22nd to Wednesday, November 25th. What is? It just has that date at the top corner. It doesn't say anything about what that is. Well, Luigi's Mansion's already $40 right now. Oh, yeah. No, Black Friday deals on the Switch. Can I get this now? Yeah. Okay. You might be able to get these deals right now.
There you go.
I'll have to check that out. That's actually... So what is that? Retro... I'm going to just put retro games, buy two, get one free.
Yeah.
Buy two, get two. We'll see how far that stretches, because they have like actual retro stuff too.
Yeah.
That I like to shop every once in a while.
I mean, this circular specifically said PS3, 360, Wii, Wii U, original DS, and Vita.
Right. Ultimate gift bag. So, buy the bag for $5. Get 25% off all toys, apparel, collectibles, drinkware, statues, and board games. Oh, it's the Mario bag.
Yeah.
I saw that on the internet.
So the second to last page just basically says when these are. It says Black Friday countdown in store and online November 14th to the 21st, which means it's been over. Black Friday early deals in store and online the 22nd to the 25th. So till tomorrow. Black Friday online starts tomorrow at 8 p.m. Central Time. And it starts in stores Friday at 7 a.m.
They did a terrible job of putting a distinction on what is going to be on sale when.
Yeah.
They should have... When I worked at GameStop, they had like colors, like a color chart and like tiers of when things would be on sale. They should have done that.
Yeah.
Should have put everything in yellow. That's going to be like an early deal, and like put a little black thing for Black Friday deals.
This isn't the same GameStop that you worked for, Bob. This is the GameStop that now has TikTok competitions in order to extend your hours.
Yep.
So
I could see like people wanting to do that. Because it was getting hours at for your store was mm-hmm. always very hard. Anyway, it looks like the Black Friday deals are going to be online, and they do start November 25th at 8 p.m. So Central Time, 8 p.m. Central Time. So if you want any of the GameStop deals, which there weren't really that many good ones, the buy two get two free for the last for the. Two generations ago games. and the PDP fight pad. That's all I could really think of. That's it for GameStop.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, we got Walmart, which probably doesn't have anything good.
Someone just said Walmart has first-party Switch games for $30.
Oh, they do? Oh! That is the best deal for these.
Yeah.
Mario Maker 2, $30. Luigi's Mansion 2, Yoshi's Woolly World, which Splatoon 2, Super Mario U Deluxe.
What is this?
Fire Emblem Three Houses, $30.
There you go.
Mario Tennis Aces.
You all like that.
Zelda Link's Awakening, you weebs. You weebs like that shit. They also have $30 for the Power A enhanced wireless controllers, which is pretty good. $15 for some of these games. I can't see these freaking games. Rainbow Six Siege. It's on Game Pass. Sonic Mania for the Switch, $15.
There you go.
Mario Plus Rabbids, $15.
The Bioshock Collection, $15.
That's the best deal we've seen for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is making GameStop look bad too.
Yeah. Way to go, Walmart. Putting another mom and pop shop out of business.
This is weird. They have Xbox Series X, and then right under the logo, they have Xbox One controllers. I think that's messed up. And they're $40, so get out of here.
Well, to be fair, you can use an Xbox One controller on a Series X.
But it's dirty to put them right there.
True.
And they labeled them Xbox controller. They didn't even say Xbox One controllers.
They know what they're doing. They know what they're doing.
That's $22.88 for 3 months of Game Pass.
That's pretty good.
A good deal. That's a good deal.
Ooh, $44.96 for 12 months of PlayStation Plus.
Now is the time. Even if you're not up on your PlayStation Plus yet, but just buy that and tack it on.
Yeah.
I
might have to do that. Yeah.
I'm going
to
put this in a tab. It is not on sale yet. When does this happen?
Well, I know, I don't know if we'll get to it, but on the PlayStation Store, it's $44.99.
Right now?
Right now.
All right, I'll get it on there then.
Yeah.
Because they already got my information.
Oh, offer valid from November 20th to December 18th.
Okay.
So you got plenty of time to do this.
But don't forget.
No, yeah.
That's it for games on Walmart. But Walmart's got some pretty good stuff.
Yeah.
Do not buy these TVs. Do not buy a TV from Walmart. It's freaking $400 for a 58-inch. That sounds too good to be true. That's because it is. What is this?
Probably it is.
Oh, it's a Samsung.
Samsung. But you got to be careful with Walmart because Walmart they will have their house brand front and center for a 65-inch Walmart-branded TV for $100.
Mm-hmm.
And they will promote that before they promote anything else.
Right.
So just be careful if you're gonna shop for TVs at Walmart.
Yo, Bass Pro Shop though. Come on, what are we doing here? What are we getting? Here we go.
Are you not gonna check
Axis XP bolt action rifle package? Here we go.
For all your bass fishing needs.
Get that for your child, Will. A $200 Jeep.
Oh, that's like the one we had.
Are those things that? No, this one's way cooler than the one we had. Well, don't even.
Oh yeah.
Don't even pretend. Toys have gotten a lot cooler. $10
really
jeans.
Have.
$10 jeans. Bass Pro Shop.
Ooh.
All right. I guess that's the. I think that's it. That's everything.
That's
oh,
it.
Oh, we didn't do the online stores for this stuff.
Do you want to do that real quick?
Yeah, we'll do that quick because I can't imagine these being any better than the physical stores.
So for the most part, they're on par with the physical stores. In some cases, as is usually happens, it'll be cheaper to buy the physical version. Because Star Wars Squadrons is $24 on Xbox Live, whereas it was $19 at Best Buy. But that said, if you're all digital, they got some really good deals on here. Of course, the older games will be a little bit cheaper. Mafia Definitive Edition that just came out, that's $30. Resident Evil 3 is $20 on here on Xbox Live. I'm going to take advantage of Hitman 2 for $12. That's a good deal.
That is good. I don't like these deals, Will. This is good if you're all digital. Maybe you have an Xbox Series S. But then again, half of this stuff's going to be on Game Pass.
Yeah.
So I don't know if I could I don't know if I'd say go for any of this stuff, really. Hitman 2, though, 80% off. That's pretty good.
If you don't have Game Pass and you see something you've always wanted to play and it's a good deal, go for it.
Lego Marvel Super Heroes 2, $5.
There you go.
Didn't you say Gears was... How cheap was it?
One of those stores had it for... I think Best Buy had it for $5.
Yeah, it's 10 here.
Yeah. It's 10 most places.
Okay.
I just saw it and I wanted to point it out.
Adam's Venture Origins, 90% off at $1.50.
There you go. Burnout Paradise Remastered, $5 on Xbox.
I feel like I've seen it cheap like that before.
Yeah. Only on Xbox, though. On Switch, it's like, I think, $25 on sale right now.
All right, I'm moving over to PlayStation already.
Yeah.
This looks worse.
It is worse.
Ghost of Tsushima, if you have... I think this is... Actually, they don't say if you have PlayStation Plus or anything.
Yeah, I don't think it matters.
Ghost of Tsushima, $40.19. So it's 19... Yeah. No, it's 20 cents more here than it is at the other stores. But it's digital, yeah. So...
Also, I want to point out, the problem with digital is oftentimes they will also put on sale the special edition versions of the game. So I don't know if you can see it, but they have Marvel's Avengers, 50% off, $30. And then they have Marvel's Avengers Deluxe Edition, $40.
Mm.
So just be careful. If you don't want the special edition, make sure you know what you're doing. Because that happened to me. I bought Wolfenstein 2, the new Colossus Deluxe Edition for way more than I wanted to spend on it. And I didn't want the DLC. I just wanted the base game.
What is this nonsense? Watch Dogs Legion's Ultimate Edition, 33% off, but it's $80.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Jedi Fallen Order, it says EA included. What does that mean?
Oh, it's part of EA Play.
It's 60% off at $23.99. That's okay.
Yeah, that's on par with.
Jump Force, $15, baby.
There you go.
All right, I'm not liking this either.
Yeah. Well, get prepared because Nintendo is once again worse.
Cuphead, $15. Hades, $20. Everybody's loving Hades. That's a lot of people's game of the year. I might have to pick that up.
Yeah.
Just Dance, $30. Dark Souls, $20. Pretty good. Catherine, full-bodied, $30. I want to see how the story expands with the third Catherine.
I know.
Burnout Paradise, $30.
Yeah, exactly. Carry On, $15. Is that a good game, or did people just talk about it because it was gross?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I can't tell. It looks good. I think it looks good.
Yeah. No, it does look good, but it also looks very gross.
Sega Ages Sonic 2 with Knuckles, it looks like.
Yeah, they added Knuckles to it.
$6.
Yeah.
Ruiner, $10. Shantae, $10. Mortal Kombat 11, $15.
Yeah.
Shovel Knight, that's Treasure Trove, $20.
That's just the base game of Mortal Kombat 11. If you want all the DLC and stuff, I think that's still full price.
Super Hot, $15. Doom, $30. Katana Zero, $9. Buy that. Everybody buy that. It's a great game. That's it. Oh, Transistor, $4. Yeah. Bastion, $3. That's pretty good. Sonic Mania, $10. That's the best deal I think we've seen.
That's good, yeah.
And so is Sonic Forces, but don't buy that. All right, that's it.
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple of others, but those are the big ones.
Sega Genesis Classics Collection, $15. That's
a good deal.
That's, I think, my favorite classics collect. That's my favorite collection of games on the Switch, I think.
Yeah. It's also Devolver Digital games. Broforce, $374.
Broforce. Wait, which one's Broforce?
Broforce was like the shoot 'em up where everybody was named Bro.
Oh, there's Devolver.
Yeah.
Am I getting it confused with the time?
Yes.
Yes, I am. Broforce. Yeah, that's $374. Okay. What's the time one I'm thinking of? Time Force.
Yeah,
that game's great. I don't see that enough anymore. Yeah, buy Katana Zero. That game's great.
Yeah.
All right, that's it. Those are your Black Friday deals. Yeah. Nothing too crazy because we got new consoles.
Yeah.
No, no good system stuff. I didn't see any of these companies promoting the last gen consoles at all.
I mean, it makes sense they want to promote their current gen consoles, but you would think they would want to, you know, clear out the inventory of the last gen stuff.
Mm-hmm. Especially Xbox.
Yeah.
Why not?
Especially if like they're going to support the Xbox One for a little bit longer.
Like, you can sell some Xbox Ones for even $150. You know, people would still buy those.
Mm-hmm.
Throw in a game or two with them, or a gift card. That's a little weird that they didn't have those. But also, I mean, it might also be confusing with the new stuff.
Yeah.
People might accidentally buy those instead of the new stuff. All right. Bob should do a list of his favorite things like Oprah does. Jess, the vagabond. I'll probably do gift guides, like on the main channel.
Yeah. I mean, you ever see that Oprah's favorite stuff? She just lists a whole bunch of crap that people paid a lot of money to have her say she likes.
I've never actually seen it. I've only heard. I've never sat through an episode. Pork Chop, what about the Duck Game discount? Was Duck Game on there?
I don't think Duck Game was on there, but they might have.
Are those deals available right now?
Yes.
Duck Game. Oh, I can't see because I have the game. I hate.
On. I hate got it. It's loading.
Is Katana Zero a Metroidvania? No. It is linear. It is very linear.
$12.99. That's full price.
Yeah, it's not a good deal. I mean, it's a great game.
Yeah.
We got Dizzy Frog HS with the Twitch Prime. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. We got a lot of news here. I kind of want to get rid of half of it.
Okay.
I think we should talk about this.
Whatever you don't want to talk about, just skip.
I think we should talk about this first because a lot of people were asking me about this because I'm that guy, Will. There's a new little emulation device made by, I think, the guys at BitBoy.
Okay.
But it's a collaboration with 8-Bit Do. It's very confusing.
Yeah.
So let's break it down. We got obscurehandhelds.com. Never heard of this site before, but here we go.
Seems legit.
Hot off the presses comes another handheld from the makers of the Pocket Go series. Okay, so I think that's the BitBoy people. The Pocket Go SN30. If the SN30 name sounds familiar, it's because there's a line of controllers from 8-Bit Do with the same name. Word is that the designer of those controllers also had a hand in designing the Pocket Go SN30. If you click on that little link,
it brings
you to his website. He must be Chinese because it's in Chinese. And you go to his project. He's got some weird designs. I didn't know about this 8-Bit Do desktop arcade. This looks pretty sick. But yeah, you could tell this is the friggin' guy who designed the 8-Bit Do stuff. So yeah, anyway, I've known about this handheld for a while now, but until today, I hadn't seen the final renders and videos of it in action. The specs of the Pocket Go SN30 are a little different to other recent handhelds, too. Let's have a look at what we know so far. The Pocket Go specs. It's highly probable that the SN30 will be powered by an all-winter A33. The prototype units have been built with this CPU already, and it's the same chip found in the NES Classic.
Oh.
The A33 is an efficient ARM Cortex A7 chip from 2014 with four 1.2 gigahertz cores and whatever, blah, 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 technical stuff. Whilst this chip is leaps and bounds faster than the one found in the RG350 and its kin, I believe it doesn't quite it doesn't perform quite as well as the one that's in the RG351P, which is this guy, the like newer right. version of the 350. The SN30 is currently configured with 512 gigabytes of RAM. So basically, it's going to be like all the other ones. The LCD is a standard fare these days, 3.5 inch IPS with resolutions of 480 by 320. They all have that. The Pocket Go SN30 handheld is apparently running the same OS as the Pocket Go version 1 with a new front end. It's proprietary OS designed to be as simple to use as possible for the end user. So this article has actually been updated from what I've read before.
Okay.
Because before, when I read this, it said it didn't know if it was a 3-inch screen or a 3.5 inch screen. And it said that it didn't know if it was running or what it was running. And now it's saying that it's right. running the same OS as the Pocket Go version 1. Which I liked. I liked that OS. For anyone not keen on Emulek or OpenDingux, like maybe you will, this yeah. handheld might be for you. You can easily load ROMs to this device either by sticking the SD card into your PC or by connecting the device with a USB cable. No special software is required to access the contents of the SD card. It can be read and written to natively in Windows. That's a big problem with these emulation devices, is getting ROMs on there is remarkably horrible.
Yeah.
Like, that's the one thing that you have to make easy on these things. And it's a remarkably bad experience on a lot of these emulation devices. But apparently they're working on making sure this runs good. I guess this either means there's an NTFS partition on the card or the OS has been built with this in mind. There is also what looks to be a single settings menu, which apparently unifies all settings throughout the device. Full specs, I'm not reading that, but it's $70, which is pretty good. It's a pretty good deal.
Okay.
Another problem with these devices is that sometimes they have stacked shoulder buttons, like they'll be next to each other, like the R2 and R1 yeah. will be next to each other. This looks like an 8-bit Duke controller. So the R1 and R2 are, you know, in the right spot.
Yeah.
This is a really nice design, although it does seem that the secondary buttons are a little wobbly on the prototype video. Hopefully this will be remedied before mass production. I can't read. I don't know what this OS is, though. This looks like OpenDingux. And that was a massive pain in the ass to put ROMs on. So I don't really understand.
So you're not looking forward to this one?
What? No, actually, I'm sorry. It looks like Emulek, and that was a massive pain in the ass to put ROMs on. So no, right. So I don't. They're saying it's easy to put ROMs on. I feel they have to have done something. Whatever OS this is, I remember it being a pain in the ass to put ROMs on. But anyway, it looks really nice. The front of the device contains SNES-like D-pad. It also has a joystick on the bottom left. That looks mm-hmm. like the Joy-Con thumbstick that everybody's using on these emulators. It can play up to Dreamcast. I do not see N64. However, in the video, it has N64 running. So it might not be an official thing because it probably runs like crap.
Yeah.
But it's there. And there's also no right stick.
Certain N64 games will work. Yeah, like N64 usually it's like one game at a time.
Super Mario 64 usually runs pretty good. Games like Perfect Dark are not going to run good.
Yeah.
You might be aware that there are a lot of all-winner A33 devices, not handhelds, already available with Android running on them. The manufacturer is considering the possibility of adding more RAM and giving the option to run Android 2, though it will be an older version. The current configuration is 512 megabytes of RAM, but it may be possible to bump it up to 2 gigabytes at an extra cost. With that in mind, would you be interested in running Android on this handheld? It would likely mean a bump in price. I would only want that if it could run N64 better. you know, but I don't think that's going to happen. So I'd rather, I don't need another OS. Some people like Android because it's a little more customizable or at least easier to customize, but that doesn't mean it's easy to customize. It's easier to customize, but it's not easy to customize. So this is cool. I'm interested in this. I will be checking it out when it comes out. It looks like it's probably going to be a while. Do we know when the Analog Pocket is coming out?
So sometime next year. I don't think they gave a date.
I feel like they're going to push that back.
Well, first thing on their website is the whatchamacallit, the TurboGrafx-16.
Yeah, well, I mean.
Yeah. It doesn't say.
Kate McCat says, but can you eat it? I mean, you can eat anything if you try hard enough.
You set your mind to it, yeah.
Edible Jim Sock says, is Doom 3 worth $3? I'm going to say no.
Doom 3?
Mm-hmm.
For $3, I'd say yes.
Yeah, you know what? $3 is cheap. $3 is cheap.
Yeah, because it's cheap. The game itself is not bad, and all the versions now, they've patched in the flashlight that you can hold the flashlight and shoot your gun at the same time.
That is true. I forgot that they fixed that.
People would say, like, oh, no, it's supposed to be that way because it makes the game scarier. No. They didn't realize they could do both at the same time until it was too late to patch it in.
I didn't really like that game as much as everybody else did.
It was a hard game to get into back in the day. I think now, you know, if you go in with the right mindset, if you go in knowing it's a horror game and not a Doom game, I think it's a worthwhile experience.
Windy Runner says, Bob, do you think 8-Bit Do would make Super Nintendo Joy-Cons? By the way, love your vids. They haven't made any Joy-Cons so far. I think only Hori has ever made like Joy-Cons that slot in. Besides, I mean, there's also those like random like Amazon sellers. I'm going to say no. I don't think they would. Frankenstein Gaming says, been watching you for a while. Keep up the great work. You're an inspiration. Thanks, Frankenstein Gaming. I appreciate it. All right. Were you looking something up?
I was looking up the analog, but it didn't say when.
Mm. All right, let me
check their Twitter. Go on to the next thing. I'll just check their Twitter real quick.
Okay. There's actually not too much. We can plow through these. We could talk about this real quick. This is a very controversial topic. Smash Brothers Tournament, the Big House 10, has been canceled. And this article says over netcode, which is not true. That's like a gross oversimplification of the thing. Nintendo sent organizers a cease and desist, and they will comply. That's what happened. Like, that should be the title, not the subtitle. This is a short article. This is from Polygon. The Big House, one of the premier events in competitive Super Smash Brothers, must cancel the tournament's organizers had scheduled for early December after receiving a cease and desist demand from Nintendo of America. The Big House has been held with no problem every year since 2011. Nintendo's issue this year is related to the Big House organizers' plans to use Slippy, an unapproved rollback netcode that makes Super Smash Bros. Melee playable online. It's a mod also, let's not forget.
Mm-hmm.
That requires a ROM of Super Smash Bros. Melee, a tool necessary for the online event. So you do, I mean, it is necessary in order to have for the event to happen at all because Melee doesn't have online. The Big House 2020 announced back in July that its in-person event would be canceled in light of the COVID-19 pandemic. The previous four tournaments were held at TCF Center in downtown Detroit. And their statement was, the Big House is heartbroken to share we've received a cease and desist from Nintendo America to cancel our upcoming online event. We were informed we do not have permission to host or broadcast the event primarily due to the usage of Slippy, Sadly, all our competitions are affected. We are forced to comply with the order and cancel the Big House for both Melee and Ultimate. Refund information will be sent shortly. We apologize to all those impacted. On November 10th, Big House organizers announced that they would move the tournament online, set December 4th to the 6th as the dates, and began taking registrations. Now, with Nintendo cease and desist, the event has been canceled. The Big House is the longest running annual tournament in major Smash competition. I did not know that. Held every year since 2011. Last year's prize pool delivered $3,636 to Melee singles winner Joseph Mango Marquez and $4,068 to Ultimate singles champion Okada Zachary Soda. His name's not Zachary? That is not a lot of money when it comes to esports. And that's because there's no backing from Nintendo. But then Nintendo responded. And Nintendo said, Nintendo appreciates the love and dedication the fighting game community has for the Smash Brothers series. We have partnered with numerous Smash Brothers tournaments in the past and have hosted our own online and official online and offline tournaments for the game, and we plan to continue that support in the future. Unfortunately, the upcoming Big House tournaments announced plans to host an online tournament for Super Smash Bros. Melee that requires use of illegally copied versions of the game in conjunction with a mod called Slippy during their online event. Nintendo therefore contacted the tournament's organizers to ask them to stop. They refused, leaving Nintendo no choice but to step in to protect its intellectual property and brands. Nintendo cannot condone or allow piracy of its intellectual property. Before Nintendo made that statement, this story exploded.
Mm-hmm.
And people were very mad at Nintendo, as they are, as they normally are. And Nintendo has been historically bad with Smash Brothers esports. They don't help tournaments at all. They have their own tournaments, the invitationals and stuff, and those are pretty bad. But for whatever reason, they don't like the Smash Brothers community. It's made even worse with Melee, because that's an older game and they want to promote their new stuff, Ultimate. And Melee doesn't have an online component, so people had to make their own online component. A company like Sega would be like, they would pretend like this isn't happening. They would be like,
don't get in trouble. I don't care.
Or they would give them money and try to make it a real thing. For whatever reason, Nintendo doesn't want to do that. I get it. Like, I think supposedly they've allowed Slippy to be used in other tournaments, but I think this is just what I heard. I don't have any proof of this, but apparently those were invitationals, and they were regulated. So like the copies that these people were using were verified. In this case, this is an open tournament. So do you think everybody's really going to rip a copy of their GameCube Melee game? No, they're gonna download a ROM. So that's why Nintendo was like, no, you can't do this. And what it looks like to me is that Nintendo sent a cease and desist so that to tell them not to play Melee, because that requires a ROM. Like it looks like Nintendo said, do not use Slippy, you can't do the Melee tournament. And they said, we're going to do it anyway. And then Nintendo had to send a cease and desist for the entire tournament.
Yeah.
And that's where things got bad. So everybody hates Nintendo right now, and I don't really blame them. I think that it makes sense for them to want to stop a tournament that uses a pirated version of their game. Like that's just like, I don't see why they're looking like the bad guy for that. But historically, Nintendo has been terrible at supporting Smash Brothers esports at all. So
yeah,
I mean, if this is the thing that gets people riled up about Nintendo's involvement in Smash Brothers, then fine. But there were other, you know, more important things that people could have gotten mad about in the past.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, the big thing for me is that Melee is not a game Nintendo is supporting in the slightest. They have never re-released it. They have never made it available beyond what's on the GameCube. They do not make any money whatsoever from Melee anymore. And yet, now all of a sudden, they're trying to enforce their control over Melee because these people want to use a modified version of it for a specific tournament.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if Nintendo put Melee out on the Switch for you to buy right now and play, that's one thing. If they had ever supported it past the GameCube's lifespan, but they don't. So they want you to go out and buy Ultimate, which people did. Ultimate is like, what, the best-selling fighting game of all time?
Yes.
Yeah, so I don't think this tournament, Big House, is going to interfere with the sales of Ultimate in any way, shape, or form. So
no, not at all.
Yeah. That said, like, you're right. Nintendo is well within their rights to protect their intellectual property, and they feel like they need to protect Melee this way. They absolutely should do that. But, you know, prove that this is a property you care about protecting. Re-release Melee. Put it out again. You know, otherwise, you know, it's the same thing with, like, when Earthbound wasn't available for decades.
Yeah.
You know, they would like take, you know, send cease and desist to ROM sites. Meanwhile, people just want to play Earthbound and Nintendo is not making it available or easy to get to.
Yeah, the best weapon against piracy is availability. Is making these things available to people, then they won't want to pirate it. People want an online component for Melee. Nintendo's not doing it, so they made it themselves. Mm-hmm. Another problem is if they re-release Melee on the Switch, it's not going to have the same rollback netcode that Slippy has. This mod uses rollback similar to what it's a similar thing to what Mortal Kombat 11 has. Mortal Kombat 11 has like a mixture of rollback and whatever the hell the other. It has good error correction, but this has rollback, so it feels a lot better than even Smash Brothers Ultimate feels. Nintendo is very bad at netcode for their own games, so even if they release an official version of Melee for the Switch, which I mean, it's entirely possible that they do, especially now that they have a GameCube emulator that works on the Switch. If they release that and they make it online, it will not even run as good as Slippy does. And these tournaments might even still use Slippy. But again, it's within Nintendo's right to stop it because it requires a pirated copy of the game. Or a way to rip the ROM. And I mean, you know, that I've never ripped a GameCube game before. I don't even know where to start with that.
It's probably not easy. It's probably not something like the average person can do.
I've only ever ripped a Game Boy ROM, and that's not even really the way I did it. Isn't even really ripping the ROM. It just verifies that you have it and then downloads it. EIP underscore says the netcode for Splatoon 2 is the smoothest compared to the other Nintendo online games, and that is true. The Splatoon 2 has the best Nintendo made Nintendo first party netcode of any of the Nintendo games. I think that's mostly because it's not I don't want to say it's not peer-to-peer because I don't know that for sure, but there's a lot of people on both teams. All of their peer-to-peer games where it's one player versus another player, the connection is trash. And it's worse in Smash Brothers when you're doing teams of four.
Mm-hmm.
Because EIP underscore says it is peer-to-peer. It's doing something different, though, because there's like eight people on the server. You know, it's not like in Smash Brothers when you're playing for a team of four and the connection is garbage, because that's true peer-to-peer.
Yeah.
Splatoon has something else involved. The technical term might be peer-to-peer, but there's other things that are correcting the errors that might happen. All right. That's the Melee snafu that's been going on.
Yeah.
I don't know anything about this. Nintendo sues hackers.
It's... Hold on, let it load. Nintendo of America has filed a lawsuit against Amazon, Nintendo Switch hack reseller. Sort of litigation it's taken in similar cases in the past. Nintendo's lawyers allege that the Amazon seller, Lei Hong Min, circumvents Nintendo's copyright measures in selling an RCM loader used to jailbreak the Nintendo Switch. The lawsuit filed in Seattle court on Wednesday, according to court documents obtained by Polygon. In the lawsuit, Nintendo outlines what it calls a serious worsening international problem with video game software piracy. It details Nintendo's security systems, how the RCM loaders bypass those systems. The RCM loader, which is essentially a USB device that plugs into the Nintendo Switch, allows the user to play so-called pirated or unauthorized games. According to the lawsuit, Nintendo sent a DMCA notice to the seller, to which a counterclaim was issued. Because of this counterclaim, Amazon was required to relist the RCM loader unless Nintendo had filed an infringement lawsuit, and that's what it did.
So I have a video where I put Android on my Switch, and in order to do that, you need one of these RCM jigs or one of these loaders. I forgot about that. Didn't end up working for me, the RCM loader. I don't remember what it was called exactly. I'm trying to see. Oh, here it is. Okay, it was not by this guy. The ones that I got are still up on Amazon right now.
Yeah.
And if you want that, go to my video on where I put Android on the Switch, and in the description there'll be links to the ones that I used. And you might want to buy them now if you ever want to get...
because if Nintendo wins this case, look out, because like, they don't have to sue. Everyone's just going to take them down out of fear.
Yeah, or Amazon might step in and take them down themselves.
But this is an example of Nintendo exerting their protection over their IP for a thing that they are currently selling and currently, you know, intending to make money off of. This makes sense. The Melee thing, not so much.
Well, I don't know. I think the biggest problem is that they're advertising it as a hack for the Nintendo Switch.
Right.
And that has Nintendo's name on it, and I think they have a right to cease and desist that. I don't know about suing. Like,
if it's, you know, the explicit purpose is for pirated games, that's well within their right to sue for that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you could make the argument that once you buy the Switch, it's your device, you can do with it whatever you want. But, you know, the way all of technology is now, the software on that device is also protected by IP laws. So Nintendo can step in and prevent people from doing things with the software on the device.
Oh, that's okay. That's the problem. It's not the jig itself that's the problem, or the RCM loader itself. It's the software that's on the RCM loader. That makes sense. Why there would be a lawsuit.
Yeah.
Conversely, we don't have an article for this, but it looks like the hacks for the Xbox One S the Xbox Series S are up and running, baby. You can run you can run friggin' every emulator ever on that thing, and it's super easy. Xbox has like a development mode. And you just friggin' load up RetroArch and you could just do whatever the hell you want with it. Which might be a future video, but I think I watched a Modern Vintage Gamers video on it.
Yeah.
And I think Linus Tech Tips is already working on a video on it. Anyway, Yeah, so if you want an RCM jig or an RCM loader, go buy it now, because you might not be able to get it soon. Apple cuts App Store take in half. Is this a response to Epic Games?
Yeah, so long story short, and it's not across the board. Apple today announced an industry-leading new developer program to accelerate innovation and help small businesses and independent developers propel their business forward with the next generation of groundbreaking apps on the App Store. The new App Store Small Business Program will benefit the vast majority of developers who sell digital goods and services on the store, providing them with a reduced commission on paid apps and in-app purchases. Developers can qualify for the program and a reduced 15% commission if they earn up to $1 million in proceeds during the previous calendar year. So basically, it's the new program is if your app makes less than $1 million, Apple will only take a 15% cut of the revenue.
Where they took 30 before?
They took 30 before. That 30% cut was for every app across the board, no matter what. Now, if you're a small business and your app makes less than $1 million, Apple will only take 15%.
That's pretty great.
It is. It's a good start. No, it is. But, I mean, you know, because a company like Epic is going to be like, that's not good enough. You got to do it for everybody.
Well, Epic claimed they were fighting for the little people. They claimed, right, we have the money. We have the... we can take a hit. Like, if you take us off the App Store, we'll be fine. So here, yeah, we're going guns blazing for the little, yeah, people. So they kind of won. They got what they said they wanted. Now, right, let's see if they actually wanted that. Also, for Apple, for Apple, I'm sure that like 90% of their revenue is from the top earners anyway. The, yeah, people who make more than $1 million. So this probably means nothing to them.
Yeah.
This is probably just a good faith move because they know it's going to be good for everybody. And it gets people in, yeah, the door. Like the Flappy, yeah, Birds, like, will, mm-hmm, be able to get in the door easier.
While comprehensive details will be released in early December, the essentials of the program's participation criteria are easy and streamlined. One, existing developers who made up to $1 million in 2020 from all of their apps, as well as developers new to the App Store, can qualify for the program and the reduced commission. Two, if a participating developer surpasses the $1 million threshold, the standard commission rate will apply for the remainder of the year. Three, if a developer's business falls below the $1 million threshold in a future calendar year, they can re-qualify for the 15% commission the year after.
Okay, so it's like a tax. It sounds like taxes.
Basically.
It sounds like a tax bracket.
It also sounds like it's not just for one app. It's for, like, if I put out three apps on the App Store, if all of my apps combined make more than $1 million, then I bump up to the 30%.
You're going to see a lot more developers on this thing. You're going to see people who have one company who are going to have, like, four different development, like names, you know.
Yeah, it's gonna be like in the early days of the Nintendo Entertainment System. History lesson for all you kids out there: when the NES first came out, Nintendo limited third parties to only release 5 games a year. So to get around that, a lot of companies created shell companies to put out more games for the system. One of the most famous of which was Konami had a shell company called Ultra Games and would release games through that company rather than the main company. So games like Metal Gear Solid, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, those were released under the Ultra brand, even though they were owned by Konami.
Nintendo has been doing bullshit since then. You know? That's like, yeah, ridiculous. But also, I mean, look at the Wii. Look at all the shovelware that was on the Wii.
Yeah.
Maybe they were trying to prevent something like that. But I mean,
well, they were trying to prevent, because the Atari 2600, any company could just put a game on it and just release a lot of shovelware crap. Mm-hmm. Nintendo was trying to prevent that from happening But the downside to it was companies that actually did make good games were hamstrung by it. So they had to find a workaround.
I want to say the illustrations on this article are great. What is this?
Well, yeah, I mean...
Oh, it's apple.com.
Yeah.
Oh.
Pay for the best.
Stupid-ass biased website. I want to point out that Expiation in the chat found an article that explains Splatoon 2 netcode very well. It's oatmealdome.me. So search Splatoon 2 netcode. It looks like it uses PIA, which is a version of peer-to-peer. Basically, it's peer-to-peer-to-peer-to-peer-to-peer-to-peer-to-peer. So like, whereas peer-to-peer is one to the other. This uses a mesh of all of the peers from what my quick glance is. So it implements network features based on peer-to-peer architecture, unlike the traditional client-server architecture. This means that instead of one server being a one-on-one conversion between each Nintendo Switch console to exchange information, all of the consoles communicate directly with each other to share information. So that way, if one console drops out, the others can fill in the gaps.
Interesting.
However, this doesn't mean that there isn't a master console similar to what a server would be. PIA assigns one console as the host of the session. I don't know about that, because supposedly that's not how Smash works. Supposedly there isn't a host console. But I certainly have felt like there is when I play Smash Brothers. But also, I'm pretty sure Smash Brothers, if one console has a bad connection, they all have a bad connection.
Yeah.
So I think that's a true peer-to-peer. Crispy X says, peer orgy. If you want more information, read this article. It's oatmealdome.me. What else can we plow through here? This is for you. IO Interactive making a 007 game.
Yes, IO Interactive, the makers of the Hitman franchise, now have a new project in the works, and it is Project 007, a brand new James Bond video game being developed and published by IO, featuring a wholly original Bond story. Players will step into the shoes of the world's favorite secret agent to earn their 00 status in the very first James Bond origin story. IO Interactive is currently recruiting elite talent from around the world to join the team and will build out this exciting and unique gaming title. So if you need a job, IO Interactive is hiring. You can work on this 007 game.
So they made the Hitman games.
Yes.
You like that?
Yes. And I think it makes perfect sense for them to do James Bond, because Hitman is like a world of secret agents. It's very much it's a stealth game. It fits well in that world of like espionage and spy shit and cool gadgets.
I could see that translating also, like, very well.
Yeah, and also like this aura of the debonair around Hitman. Because you go to like elegant parties and galas, and Agent 47 is always in like a nice suit. So that would just be perfect for like, that translates perfectly well to James Bond. I honestly can't think of a better developer for this. You know,
it's not going to be like your GoldenEye or your
Perfect Dark. And honestly, at this point, I don't want it to be. I want it to be something else.
Nobody has been nobody's been able to capture that magic.
No. Give EA all the shit you want. They deserve it. But to be fair, they did a lot of good when they had the James Bond license. They put out some good games. Some of them tried to be GoldenEye, but a lot of them tried to be their own thing. And when they tried to be their own thing, it was really cool. And then Activision took over the rights and just made Call of Duty clone one after the other. Mm-hmm. And then shat the bed with it completely. Mm-hmm. So I'm glad, because James Bond at this point is as much a video game series as it is a movie series or a book series. And I'm glad that it's finally getting like a top tier video game again. So, you know, this will be an excuse for me to upgrade to a next-gen console, let me tell you.
I think the problem is there's been a lot of garbage 007 games.
There's been a lot of garbage licensed games in general, to be sure.
True.
Yeah.
True.
And, you know, yes, 007, for every GoldenEye, there's a Tomorrow Never Dies or 007 Racing or 007 Legends, which is absolute, which, all of them are absolute
crap. I can honestly only think of two good ones. There's GoldenEye, and there's the one that was like, Everything or Nothing.
Those are the best, without a doubt. From Russia with Love is very, very similar to Everything or Nothing. We did a backlog video on that. Nightfire was a really good one. And the N64 version of The World Is Not Enough is very, very good. The GoldenEye remake on the Wii wasn't bad. But other than that, none of the Activision James Bond games are anything to write home about at all.
Right. So this has potential to be really good.
Yes.
MGM needs some money, don't they?
Yeah. I didn't even think they were a movie studio anymore, to be honest with you.
I think they only do James Bond.
Basically, yeah. I mean, Eon Productions owns the James Bond franchise, but like, I think they, because they have a licensing deal with MGM, they're keeping MGM afloat.
MGM is on this. I didn't know Eon had the license, but yeah. MGM is on this as, you know, one of the people.
Right. Yeah. I think this is off topic, but I remember recently, the most recent James Bond game, No Time to Die, was going to go to Netflix or Apple TV, like, instead of going to theaters. But the problem was Eon was asking for like $600 million for the movie in order to compensate for the lack of box office they would have gotten had they released it in theaters.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody wanted to pay that price.
I don't
for
blame
one
them.
Movie.
And it's like a crapshoot. A lot of these movies that are going straight to streaming aren't doing too good. But it's because they ask for an insane amount of money.
Right. Well, it'd be interesting because the Wonder Woman 1984 is going straight to HBO Max on Christmas Day.
Right.
Which Warner Brothers owns HBO, so that's easy for them to do.
Trolls 2 was a good example. That did really well. It's insane, but it did apparently do really well. But then you have things like Mulan that didn't, but it's because they asked for an insane amount of money.
They asked for a $30 premium. Well, if you think about it, a $30 premium to watch a movie, like, that's one thing, because it would have cost $30 for just me and my wife to go to the movies, let alone bring in a whole family. But the problem is they were asking for $30 in addition to the $8 a month you were already paying them for Disney Plus.
Right.
And then in a few months, it's going to be free on Disney Plus anyway.
So that's your popcorn, and you don't even get that.
Yeah, exactly.
I think that there's huge potential for just going straight to streaming. I just think that they're not doing it right now. They're doing a terrible job of it.
Yeah.
Do we care about the Cyberpunk? I mean, it leaked, but it's just too, like, drunk idiots like leaked it, right?
Basically, yeah. I mean, it's mostly because we talked about Cyberpunk went gold, but then it got delayed again. One final delay till December 10th. And we talked about how going gold basically means the game is done and ready to be pressed to disc. But they're using these extra few weeks to like put out another spit shine on it to make sure it's like as optimized as possible for not just the current, again, not just last generation, but next generation as well. But apparently, again, it got pressed to disc, so it could be shipped out. And apparently some copies got shipped out already and people got their hands on it. So had they just kept their release date, this wouldn't have happened.
I mean, IGN just played 16 hours of it or something. So like, what's the big deal that it was that the footage was leaked?
Well, giving it to the press and giving it to some random schmuck are two different things. When you give it to the press, like, they're, you know, you control the message. You tell them, okay, you can play this much of the game. You can go here, here, and here. Don't go here. Don't do that. You know, if like we got our hands on it. We're not in league with CD Projekt Red. We don't know anybody over there. We could just do whatever we want. We could possibly show something that they didn't want us to show.
Right, right.
Maybe there's a mission that's broken and they need these extra weeks to fix it, but we find that broken mission.
Maybe the facial animations look bad and we get that out in front of the news and then everybody hates the game all of a sudden.
Exactly.
Yeah, I didn't watch it and I don't really care. I can wait. I can wait.
I mean, I didn't watch it either. Yeah, I'm waiting. I've had a mild saga trying to pre-order that game and it's all my fault.
What's the problem?
So originally I bought the physical copy on Amazon because it was $50. I changed my mind and I wanted to get the digital version just because I want to try and like be better about not getting discs. I want to be better about going all digital, especially for the next generation. So I canceled my pre-order and I went to go buy it digitally through Amazon. The wrinkle is I wanted to use my Amazon credit card points, and you can't use your credit card points for digital purchases on Amazon.
I did not know that. That's stupid.
Yeah. So what I did, you can use your credit card points, however, to buy physical gift cards, and the gift cards you can use to buy digital content. So I bought a physical gift card for the exact amount of money for Cyberpunk, including New York State tax.
Oh my good Lord.
And I pre-ordered the game digitally on Amazon using a gift card that was bought with Amazon credit card points. However,
oh boy,
This is how I'll say it. They haven't charged my gift card yet, and they're not going to until the game comes out.
Right.
So I have to be now extra careful on Amazon to make sure I don't buy anything with that gift card.
Oh, that sucks because it auto puts the gift card on.
Yeah, so I'm gonna try my best not to buy anything from Amazon until December 11th.
Well, oh yeah, that's I was gonna say, just use the gift card and then charge your credit card. What's the difference? But you already made the purchase.
Yeah.
So you'd have to like return it and rebuy it.
Yeah.
That's annoying. Anyway,
so just remember, don't pre-order anything.
Yeah, never pre-order anything ever. Game Award nominees, I don't care. You got Animal Crossing, Doom Eternal, Final Fantasy VII Remake, Ghost of Tsushima, Hades, and The Last of Us Part II as Game of the Year. Mm-hmm. I only played Animal Crossing and The Last of Us Part II.
I have not played a smidgen
of Final Fantasy VII.
I did not play any of these. I have no horse in this race. Mm-hmm. So I don't really care. However, I will agree with AJ of Fanatics 4 when he tweeted something to the effect of Animal Crossing deserves to win because it's the only one that really had a true like cultural footprint this year. Mm-hmm. Everybody talked about Animal Crossing. People were buying Switches specifically to play Animal Crossing at the beginning of this pandemic. All the other games you can't really say that for.
The problem is the Game Awards kind of favors narrative games, like cinematic experiences.
No, absolutely.
So I think Ghost of Tsushima is pretty up there. A lot of people think Hades should win.
Yeah, Hades is a lot of people's favorite game, but like Ghost of Tsushima is very new. It's very fresh in people's eyes. Mm-hmm. It's very artsy fartsy. The Last of Us Part II is an established brand name. People like that game. It's I haven't played it yet, but I know that series has often gotten criticism for perpetuating just because it's dark and brutal and gritty, that makes it great stereotype. Mm-hmm. The Final Fantasy VII Remake, I don't think has a chance to win because Resident Evil 2 Remake didn't win, and that was objectively the best game of that year. Doom Eternal's not going to win because I think people already forgot about that game.
Yes. I personally think Call of Duty Warzone is the game of the year. And that's not even on this list, like, at all. Content Creator of the Year. You got a lot of
Peers. We were nominated, so screw them.
We were not. A lot of Peers. Nick Merckx, Tim the Tap Man, J. Ann Lopez, and Valkyrie. Who's J. Ann Lopez? I don't remember this. Oh, okay. I know this person. Alana Pierce, I feel like, deserved it like 2 years ago. I don't know what significantly she did this year, but like 2 years ago, she was like, that's when she like rose, you know? I don't know why this year all of a sudden she's content creator of the year. But
is she technically a content creator anymore? Because now she works for Sony Santa Monica.
That's another thing, but that like just happened.
Yeah.
But people who watch us might not know Nick Merckx, Tim the Tap Man, or Valkyrie. Valkyrie just exploded this year. She moved from Twitch to YouTube gaming and has been doing insane. So she kind of deserves it. Nick Merckx has also been doing insane numbers, but he's always been doing insane numbers. He does like 60,000 viewers daily. Tim the Tat Man, though, had the whole Fall Guys saga.
Yeah.
Where, I mean, he also does, he does like 30,000 a day, which is still insane. And they play together, Nick Merckx and Tim the Tat Man. But Tim the Tat Man had the whole Fall Guys saga where he was freaking, you know, losing. He couldn't get a crown in Fall Guys, and like he had like 300,000 people watching him just try to win. So I think Tim the Tat Man and Valkyrie kind of, you know, deserve that. I usually the content creator of the year, it's like they kind of just throw people out there, and it's people that I don't really care for, or that I don't think deserve it. But in this case, I feel like there's a lot of people here who actually are like doing really great. Maybe it's just because I've been watching Call of Duty Warzone content, and that's like mainstream. I don't know. Anyway, the last thing here is Red Dead Online is going standalone, which is a pretty big deal.
It's going standalone. Rockstar Games will make Red Dead Redemption 2's multiplayer component, Red Dead Online, available as a standalone game come December 1st. It will launch for $4.99, a 75% discount available through February 15th on PS4, Windows PC via Epic Games Store, Rockstar Games Launcher, and Steam, and the Xbox One. The console versions will be playable on the PS5 and Xbox Series X via backwards compatibility. Red Dead Online will require up to 123 gigs of storage, according to Rockstar. Players will also have the option to purchase Red Dead Redemption 2 story mode separately and upgrade an upgrade that will also unlock all existing gameplay upgrades and content, including the Bounty Hunters expansion that is launching next week. And Red Dead Online, players create and control a character in the Wild West world of Red Dead Redemption 2. Each lobby typically hosts around 30 players or so that roam around the world and play the whole bunch of different scenarios. Though it's not as popular as Grand Theft Auto 5's GTA Online, it's definitely a solid, consistent, has a solid, consistent player base. Alongside the announcement of the standalone game, Rockstar also announced new details on Red Dead Online's upcoming Bounty Hunters role expansion. This update will be available starting next week, according to Rockstar.
All right, that's where we're good.
Yeah, so basically, half of Red Dead Redemption is going to be available for $5 starting December 1st.
There's a lot in Red Dead Online, but it's nowhere near the amount of stuff that's in Grand Theft Auto Online.
Yeah, I feel like this is an attempt to get people to actually play Red Dead Online, because it did not do anywhere near what Rockstar thought it was going to.
Yeah, this is like a last ditch effort to get people interested, I think.
Yeah.
I liked the original multiplayer in Red Dead Redemption.
Yeah, that was fun.
Yeah, so I don't it says $5 though. If it was free, I'd give it a shot. But also 123 gigabytes, that costs some space, you know?
Yeah, that's the other thing too. Like, you're basically paying for what should be a free to play game if it's just the multiplayer. You know, Red Dead Redemption 2 is often $20, so if you save a little bit, you can get the full experience for the same amount of hard drive space.
Yeah. All right, do we do unboxing or tweet of the week?
Unboxings, then tweet of the week.
All right, I gotta do it real quick because we're running out of time here. Is this camera gonna work? I'm sideways. Why isn't this camera working? Hello, camera. Hello.
You might just have to hold it up to your.
Hello, camera.
Making good radio.
I want the camera to work.
I do have a snack.
What do you have, Will?
I got my Nature Valley biscuit.
That's working.
I also have a Kit Kat, which I haven't eaten yet.
All right, I got my camera to work. All right. I'm just going to be sideways, whatever. I don't care. All right, we got a couple things. Yep. We got all these things. These are from Extreme Rate something. These are little Ziploc baggies. I don't know why this camera's so dark. It's as bright as it can go. These are little rubber for this looks like a sex toy. But it is rubber grips for your controllers.
Interesting.
This one's the PS5 controller, right? It looks like it.
Yeah, it looks like it.
I sweat all over my controllers. I just turn on my PS5. Damn it. I don't know, dude. It's like massaging my hands while I'm.
Oh, wow.
I don't know. This is a bra for your controllers. It feels cool, but I don't think I need this in my life, to be completely honest. What else did they give me?
Is it just PS5 or other systems?
This one is also PS5. I should have put the white one on. This one is...
That one looks like it has extra textured grip.
Ooh, this one's another... these all have different textures. I mean, this one's cool. This one is straight up a sex toy. This one's like massaging me. The other ones don't look like they would.
Yeah.
You got black, you got a weird green, you got white, but they all have different textures. And then you have like a bluish.
Yeah.
This one's got the same texture as one of the other ones. I like this one the best. It doesn't look as good.
The sex toy?
The sex toy one. It has sex with your hands while you're playing. That's pretty cool. Nice. That's Extreme Rate something or other. Thanks, dude. It's on Amazon. Now, this is the thing, What are you asking?
I was going to ask if they make for other systems or if right now it's just PS5.
I have no idea. Well, they should have left a note. Right. They also gave these little, like, controller grip things.
Right.
Thumbstick grips. This is the thing, Will.
Oh.
Fogs.
Oh.
Everyone loves a fog. Check it out. They gave me a nice box. Inside this nice box, you got whatever this is. What is this? Oh, a little like activity book. A compact compendium of concept art. Oh, that's freaking cool. You know how I love me some art book, Will.
Yeah.
That's freaking cool. I'm going to look through that later. They gave me a shirt. I love my other fog shirt. So let's see this one. Very nice. Very nice. Fogs is a game for Steam and Switch and maybe some other consoles. It's basically cat dog, but instead of cat dog, it's dog dog.
It's dog dog.
It's very good from what I played at PAX so far. And I think I just got a code in my email. I wonder what's inside. Let's take a woof.
Nah, I get it.
Oh, no. Let's looky woof. Mine was better. Make your own glorb. Does this glow in the dark?
What is a glorb in the lore of fogs?
I don't know, Will. Also, this was outside of the box, but I put it in the box. They gave me four of these, so you can have one, Will. It's a thank you for playing Cake Bash, and it's a pin.
Aw.
This is a very nice collection they gave us.
Yeah.
I got little gummies. Are these like habanero? Oh, they're spicy gummies.
Oh, wow.
Chili cherry. I'm going to try one.
I'm always wary of like candy that's also spicy.
I don't know if they're spicy. I'm just kind of imagining that they're spicy.
Like why would I want that?
I'm gonna try one. Let's see if they're spicy. Oh, it's half licorice.
Nah.
Oh, and that's a little spicy.
Like cinnamon is pushing it. And then you have like habanero and peppers and stuff. Like,
is this cinnamon? I don't know what I'm experiencing right now. The licorice, I'm not having it.
Mm-hmm.
A little Fogg's pin. And here you go, baby. Dog toys. And they gave me two. One for me, one for the dog. I appreciate that. And there's one more thing here. Me and AJ are going to play through this game on stream. It's going to be a good time. What is this now? What is this? Is this a glorb?
It's a ball.
It's just a ball. Open. It might need a battery.
Could be a light.
It definitely lights up. It might have a face to it. I don't know. We'll do that later. Let me get Rue. Rue! Where's Rue?
Bob's off to go find his dog. I am Solez. Will must not like Mexican candy. Is Mexican candy spicy? I've never had it. It's just like, if you're trying to get something sweet, yeah. Why sweet? Would you... Oh, never mind. Bob's playing with his dog.
It does not squeak. Sit. I don't think you know that's a toy. Oh, he got it.
Nah, yay.
I'll have to take my word for it. There you go. All right.
Bob is back.
Bob's back. Dog took it and ran. Couldn't really get him on camera. All right. Real quick. Also, thank you, Fox. I will play the game and have a good time. It's time, Will.
All right. Give the music.
Tweet of the week. Tweet of the week. Tweet of the week.
This one's by Phil or at Warm4Loco. Would you... I can't. I already screwed it up. You wouldn't gob a ghoul. It's in the font of the... You wouldn't download a car or whatever it is.
I remember seeing that.
The anti-piracy PSA.
Yeah.
All right, really quick, we're going to talk to you people.
Yes. As always... You can leave a... If you left a comment on the... I need to come up with a better intro for this. If you left a comment on the YouTube archive version of this over on Wolf Den Podcast, this is the part of the show where we will answer it. And of course, ladies and gentlemen watching us at home, please start leaving your questions and comments. We will get to them when we are done with everybody else.
We got True Fernie who says, the perfect thing to listen to with my morning coffee. I'm glad we're not enraging you in the morning.
Yeah.
Keyhole says,
I'm glad we're...
Continue.
I was going to say, I'm glad we're there with your poop aid. Coffee makes you poop.
Keyhole says, seriously, Nintendo would make mad bank on a Game Boy Classic, but a beautiful little IPS display in that, and put a beautiful little IPS display in that and let it play Game Boy Color too. It'd be glorious. Please, Nintendo, bless us with your merchandise. I think that's going to end up being Pokemon's job. I think the Pokemon
Probably,
company's going to do that.
You mean the little Game & Watch was not enough for you? can I just say, this might be the worst way to play Super Mario Brothers in 2020.
There's a lot of ways, and you might be right. The worst official way, at least.
Yes. Not fun. Like, it's too small, too cramped.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot you got it yourself.
Yeah. Follow us on Twitter if you want to know that saga.
I told it last week.
I will give it to my kid when she is old enough to play games because I think she'll enjoy it. I'll just play it One of the other thousand ways I could play that game.
Greg Bad Wolf says, miss Will, but great podcast, AJ. Geez says, the dude on the left got a few things wrong. I guess that was AJ. The PS5 and Xbox Series X did get next game tested by Digital Foundry. The PS5 had more consistent FPS than the more raw, powerful Xbox Series X. What? All right, what game were we talking about? Spider-Man Remastered has an upgrade fee. If you think it's not a huge upgrade, just play Spider-Man at 60. It has an upgrade fee unless you get the Ultimate Edition.
The upgrade fee is you have to buy the game again.
No, with the Ultimate Edition, I think you get the next-gen version already.
Of Miles Morales.
Yeah. 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 Chat, help me out.
It wasn't clear how you got... If you own Spider-Man on PS4, it wasn't clear how you could get Spider-Man on PS5.
Right.
But you had to put money down for it.
Unless, I think, you get the special edition.
Of Miles Morales.
Correct. Oh, we're talking about Spider-Man Remastered has an upgrade fee. Oh, yes. I don't think we talked about that last week. I think we were only talking about Morales. At least, well, you know what? I don't know. I don't know what we're talking about still. Yeah, I think you're right. If you remastered, there is an upgrade fee.
This is from the PlayStation blog back in September. We are excited to announce that a voucher code for Spider-Man Remastered will be included with Miles Morales Ultimate Edition on the PlayStation 5.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So you have to have gotten the Ultimate Edition of Miles Morales.
To even get remastered at all.
Yes.
So if you have Spider-Man for PS4 and you want to upgrade to the remastered version, there is a fee, is what you're saying.
Yes, you have to buy a completely new game. Mm-hmm. They don't just give you the updated version like smart delivery would.
Right. My concern last week was getting Miles Morales for PS4 and then upgrading it to the PS5 version later. Because there is a way to do that, but it's unclear exactly how to do that.
The PS4 version of Miles Morales offers a free upgrade path to the PS5 standard version. And if you purchase or upgrade to the PS5 standard edition, you can take advantage of a paid upgrade offer from the in-game menu to download Spider-Man Remastered.
Mm-hmm.
So... no matter what, if you want Spider-Man Remastered, you have to spend money on it via Miles Morales. You can't just buy Spider-Man Remastered, and you can't just upgrade your current Spider-Man game to Remastered. You have to buy a special edition of Miles Morales, or you have to upgrade your base edition of Miles Morales.
I don't remember ever talking about Spider-Man Remastered last week. So maybe that just flew over my head.
Maybe.
I just want to clear these two things up because Xbox fanboys keep spreading lies going unchallenged by most people. Are we the Xbox fanboys? Oh, we must be because what? The PS5 and Xbox Series X games tested by Digital Foundry, the PS5 had more consistent frames than the more powerful Xbox Series X. Then why does Call of Duty run at 120 frames on a Series X and 60 on PS4, PS5?
Yeah, what lies are you talking about?
I don't know.
See, Phil Spector, in that same interview, we're talking about smart TVs getting Game Pass, also talked about the one thing he would change about the industry is tribalism.
I feel like Xbox gets the worst end of it. Like, yeah. Nintendo has the fanboys that... shit on Nintendo, but Xbox has the fanboys of the other consoles shitting on them.
Yeah,
because they have the least helpful audience at all.
Yeah.
Sleeping Virus says, no gaming platform supports my country, the Bahamas, so we just use the US eShop and Play Store and etc. And while Our dollar is only like 5 cents less than the US last time I checked. To get games at the exact same price, rather than pulling in credit card info, I get gift cards off of Amazon. The money converter doesn't work so well. I get gift cards for the regular price, $64.59.99 and so on. Maybe this can help out our Aussies. I mean, I like using my own region's eShop. Like, I don't want to, like, I mean, I bought the 3D collection on the Japanese eShop, but then I bought it again on the American eShop just because I wanted it on the American eShop.
Right.
But yeah, there you go. If you got problems like this person does in the Bahamas, then maybe just go all American.
Yeah.
I'd imagine the Australian eShop has a little bit better support than the Bahamas situation.
Yeah, I think the Australian eShop is like an actual eShop.
Right. All right, we'll talk to you people very quick because we are...
Yeah, make it good.
We're over time here. Where were we with the notifications? You read them last.
Everything has to load because my computer is dumb.
Eric, were you correct, reading them before when I was
no,
playing
you were,
with the dog?
You were reading them before. I read one regular.
Oh, okay.
Not any of the super chats or whatever.
Kate McCat with 100 bits. On the topic of this, I don't know what you're talking about. Did you guys see the issues where streamers were getting banned for streaming Age of Calamity early, even when it was technically out in other countries? I did.
No, I didn't see that.
That's messed up because I usually will go to the store and just get a copy of the game early and play it and stream it like the day before it actually comes out. So I could have gotten DMCA'd for streaming it, but I didn't. I just got it on the eShop and played it, you know, the day it was out. So that's messed up that they did that. Now it makes me scared to stream Nintendo games when they, you know, a little early.
Yeah.
Dark Type with 6 months. 6 months here as a sub. Wow. Hi, Will and Bob. Hello.
Hey.
Proud Prince with 100 bits. Any games you have good memories of games you played while staying in a hotel room? I have two memories. I have the memories of the little N64 controller that plugs into the TV that they have in the hotel rooms.
Yes.
I think Nintendo has a video on those.
Yeah. One time we were at a hotel and we played the Super Nintendo version of it.
Oh.
I remember that.
I was going to say, one time, for whatever reason, we brought our PS2 with us.
Yes.
And we played San Andreas in the hotel room.
Yeah.
And Dad was like, get the ambulance, run people over.
Yeah. And our mother was like flabbergasted that they were cursing on the screen. She couldn't handle it.
Why? Were we in like...
We were in high school.
Yeah, but why did we bring the PS2? Were we going to like a casino or something? We weren't allowed?
No, there was a part where we were bringing video games to give us something to do just in a hotel afterwards. The one I was going to bring up was I have memories of like when we used to go snowboarding, of playing Medal of Honor Rising Sun on GameCube, like multiplayer with our friends.
We brought the GameCube?
Yeah.
I don't remember that at all.
I remember that. That was a good time. But yeah, for some reason we were bringing like our GameCube and our PS, because we figured out that you can hook up, certain TVs do let you hook up video game system to them. This is back when it was composite cables,
right,
and whatnot. So when we figured that out, we brought them and see if we could do it. And I remember we played in San Andreas, and our mother, who apparently has never heard foul language in her life before, just could not take, you know, all these 16-bit characters, 16-bit, you know, 128-bit characters saying foul things.
Our mother, the one who calls me a piece of shit.
Yes.
All right, we're in the chat for 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Crispy X, she probably loved when you picked up the hook, when you picked the hooker up, had sex, killed her, and then took her money back. Yeah, that's what I did. You can beat people with a dildo in that game.
Yes, you can. Before Saints Row made it cool.
Hot Pancake says, I had the small screen attachment they made for the GameCube and played that in the hotel room. It was awesome, LOL. I remember trying to steal
a friend of mine had it and I wanted to steal it from him, but he never got away with it.
I kind of still want that.
Yeah. Is it expensive now? That's something I would imagine fetching a pretty penny on eBay.
Yeah. And it also they also had a battery attachment for the bottom, didn't they?
Yeah. EIP, the upgrade fee is $20 if you bought the launch edition of Miles Morales.
The upgrade from
the upgrade from the stand to the special edition to get Spider-Man Remastered.
Oh, okay. So if you have Miles Morales for the regular, but you still need the PS5 version.
Yes.
Okay. Oh, wait, hold on, wait. You can have the PS4 version of Miles Morales, do the free upgrade, and then pay $20?
Yes.
Okay.
Either way, because what's the special edition's like $60?
70.
Of Miles? 70. Oh.
I believe. Yeah.
And what's Miles Morales regularly is $50?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep, $50. So
either way, you have to spend $70 mm-hmm. to play Spider-Man Remastered. Mm-hmm. You're basically buying the game again.
And then some.
And then some.
But you're getting Miles Morales with it.
You're getting Miles Morales.
It's cool if you haven't played Spider-Man, but if you have, then don't do it. Yeah. Because it's the same freaking game with some with a prettier skin on it.
And a different looking Peter Parker.
Mighty Ike says, question, is Halo a one-hit wonder? What? After the first three, it never hit. That's not a one-hit wonder then. After the first three, it never hit the same hype or mythology. What can Halo do to become mainstream? Do they look at COD or Doom for inspiration? Halo 3 was the peak, but it wasn't the peak of its popularity. It was the best game that they made, but Halo 5 still sold an amazing amount. You know?
Yeah, Halo is one of those franchises that, like, no matter the quality of the game itself, it'll still sell a lot of copies, and it will be, you know, the most popular thing on the Xbox, at least for the time. I think that the problem is Call of Duty comes out every year. Halo only comes out, like, once every 3 or 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
So in that gap, unless Microsoft is putting out new content for it regularly, you know, it's going to get lost in the shuffle of all this other stuff.
I think saying that Halo 3 was the peak is like saying that Modern Warfare 2 was the peak of Call of Duty. You know, like, they're still doing great.
Yeah.
All right, I think we're good. We gotta bounce.
Okay. Yeah.
Guys, appreciate you being here. Thank you all for hanging out.
Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching us. Thank you for chatting with us. As always, ladies and gentlemen, the Wolf Den podcast is every Tuesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern right here on twitch.tv/wolfden. If you can't make the show for any reason at all, we put the archive version of it over on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/wolfdenpodcast. So you can go there and watch it on demand whenever you want. If you prefer to listen to us rather than watch us, you can do that as well. We're also an audio podcast available on anchor.fm/wolfdenpodcast and on your favorite podcast service of choice. If we're not on your favorite podcast service of choice, let me know on Twitter and I will make damn sure it happens.
Everybody have a wonderful Thanksgiving if you're in the U.S. Yes. If you're not in the U.S., have a wonderful Black Friday. Enjoy time with your family responsibly.
Mm-hmm.
Don't see too many of them. Stay away from the old people.
No, definitely.
And try not to go out shopping on Friday if you can do it online. Try to do everything online. You probably can. Have a happy and a healthy. We'll see you all next time. Goodbye.
Bye.